Oh, we're in. I bet that's Norris. Come on, Norris. No, it's my mum. Hi, mum. I hope you're well. Lovely to see you the other day. Let's wait for some other people. Aaron, Ian, Simba, Corey, how you doing? Right, we'll just give it 3 or 4 minutes, get acquainted. I know it's very hard to cook and type, so if you've delegated someone to do that as well, well done then. Ask the questions. If you're cooking along, give me a thumbs up. If you're not cooking along, shut up for a sec. So yes, there we go. If you're cooking along, let me know and we'll go at that pace. And if you're not, just peter down for a bit. If you're not cooking along, hit like, hit love, share, and follow me on Instagram and YouTube. I need your love. How are we doing? Shep, Mr. Ramsey, mate, our barbecue thing is gonna be something epic. Cuz is in, Ash is in. No worries, man, how are you all doing? Katsu curry, Wagamamas have been knocking it out for ages. I'm gonna have a go at it. I'm gonna do a few changes, but nothing too stressful. The hardest bit is the sauce, which isn't that hard, and the rest of it is an absolute effing breeze. I do a lot of healthy cooking for a gym and a few other people. Friday night takeaways aren't meant to be, so do excuse that. But if you do want to get healthy or you want to learn how to cook a dish, get in touch and we can do lessons, all right? Can I call it John? John, right, before we go any further, can I call you Chalk, or is that like a massive insult? I just remember hearing it once at school. Smoking a brisket on Monday. Right, Ollie, when we do our barbecue session, we're going to do some parts to it. We're going to film in one day, but we'll do ribs, a brisket and everything at yours. It's going to be amazing. Guys, if you are ready, if your lockdown's driving you nuts and you can't wait for a barbecue in the summer with your mates, I guarantee what me and Ollie produce on video will be amazing, okay? It's not often I give other people credit. The guy can smoke and he's got a love for it, which just means everything. Evening, Romana. Sam, how are we doing? Guys, we're all good. So, hands up first. If you're not cooking, shut up. If you are cooking, say, yes, I'm cooking. What do I do next? A little bit of interaction. Now, I said before, it is very hard to type and cook, so I will go at the pace of the slowest participant and see how we go. Yeah, I know, Ollie, no worries. I will do soon, mate. Haha, thanks, John, I appreciate that. I remember, I don't know, I was in CDT in the sixth floor in that block, and someone called you Chalky, and it took me about 3 days to figure out it's because you're a teacher. But hey, those days are long gone. How are we all? How's everyone's Friday? Listen, quick shout out to, first and foremost, and something that's close to my mental awareness week, hope you're looking after yourselves. Hope your mates are okay. If not, cheeky text, it costs you nothing but time. Send them one over, make sure they're all right. If you hear if they're I'm fine, just send another one just to make sure. Long day, get on with it. Mum, right, okay. Flipping heck. Yes, Mum. Just for that, I'm gonna go super fast. Dave, get some oil in the pan. Don't worry about the chicken on the board, we'll butterfly that in a minute, okay? You've asked for it, Mum, now, haven't you? A little bit of oil in a pan, get that on the heat. Thanks, Mum. It's all about you, is it? Evening, Kate. Evening, Sid. Good names of the past. Not cooking long, but go well, mate. Thanks, Pav. Appreciate you, man. Thanks, Wooders. Woodman, Kate, Pellant, whatever. Mate, it's got to be addressed, Chalks. A lot of people don't know, and lockdown can't have been easy for a lot of people, so mental health was the way. Just got to address that and bring some awareness. I don't think awareness is enough, but we'll do what we can. Right, get your pan on the heat with a little bit of oil. Hopefully you've got some diced onion and some grated garlic and ginger. If you want to use a frying pan, that's fine. Also, full disclosure, this is where I get you. I've got a frying pan here with 5 mil. I've had a practice. You can see the crumbs in there, look. About 5 mil of oil. It's a shallow fry, not a deep fry. It's still oil, it's still fatty, it's still gonna get in the crumbs, but there we are. And there's a pan there for my greens. I don't know what you're doing for greens, if you're having salad or wilted spinach. I'm doing tender stem broccoli. What pan are you using for the sauce? Whatever you want, you can use a frying pan, I'm using a saucepan. Completely up to you, my love. We're gonna do rice as well while the sauce is reducing. If we don't do this in 45 minutes, I'll be very surprised, okay? So, pan on, let's go step by step. Sauce first. Pan on, bit of oil, in with the onions, in with the garlic and the ginger. And you want that on a low heat. There's no winners for burning or charring anything on this one, okay? So I'm just gonna get myself a spoon. Consummate professional, isn't it? So get your onions on the heat and just for a minute in the oil so they soften, and then add your garlic and your ginger. All with me so far? If you are cooking along, nice, Ruth, blast from the past. Anyway, cheers everybody. Hope your week went well. What goes well with curry? Beer. So, happy Friday night. Thanks for coming on. Thanks for everyone that shared and subscribed to the YouTube channel and loved and all the rest of it. Yes, COVID's kicked me in the teeth, or us in the teeth. But this interaction I love. It gets me jazzed, man. So I'm just gonna saute off this finely diced one onion. And then in my little very famous, if you've seen me cook before, you'll know I love these plates. They're graters for garlic and ginger. And what you can see on there is a mixture of one clove of garlic and about a thumb or an inch of ginger, okay? That's all grated in there. Meanwhile, while that onion is going, Mum, I'll go as slow as I possibly can. Take your 120 grams of rice and bang it in a pan. Oh, you can't see that. Pan. There are scales down here. 120 grams, 100 grams, whatever it is, we're gonna double it with liquid. Just bang that in a pan. And you're ready to go. Put your kettle on. Take your notes, wicked cool. No, you barbecue away, chef. Listen, I like these videos. If you cook along, it's great. If not, just go back and reference it. And then when I get a bit more time, I'll put stock videos up on YouTube. And you just click on it and fill your boots. I just want everyone, well not everyone, yeah, fuck it, the world. Sorry, oh, there's a watershed. I want everyone to be able to have more confidence in their kitchen. That's the whole point of this. Aaron, I know you're cooking along. How are you getting on, mate? If you haven't hit like it, like already, thanks, cuz, but 20 million likes from my cousin doesn't make for great following. So everyone, hit like and share, please. Right, still sweating down these onions. I've totally chosen the wrong pan for this, but I'm in it now. I'm in it to win it. Okay, after the onions are softened, pop in your garlic and your ginger, okay? Let me know if I'm going too fast. Honestly, take the time out. No great meal was made in a rush. Fast food is for losers. Just ask my barbecue buddies. You take your time over stuff, you put some love and some time and some affection into it, you'll go far. So if I am going too quickly, so there we are. This is soft plus onions, garlic and ginger. If I am going too quickly, just say, whoa, steady on, what's that? Evening, Mike, I will send you those three videos, mate. It's all right, it's nothing dodgy. Last night was a bus, so we'll change that. We'll change the date and the time so it suits the group. I like you because you swear like myself. Sheila, I've been told, requested, to tone it down. So if they slip out, someone do a bleep count for me and let me know how many times I swear this evening, and I'm gonna rein it in because apparently, well, and it's fair, if I expect you guys to share this, you know, kids picking up bad language, which I get all that. I'm sorry for all the swearing. But if you want, there is talk of a podcast, and that'll be after hours, over 18, quite explicit. And I'll be interviewing some chefs and some rugby players. That's an exclusive. Oh, it's gonna be fun. So, how are we looking, guys? If your ginger, garlic, and onions are nice and soft and not charred, then you can add your turmeric and your curry powder, okay? If you haven't got it all, don't worry. The sauce will taste a little bit different or look a little bit different, but essentially, it doesn't matter. I'd like, along with getting everyone's confidence up in their own kitchen, I'd really like people to not fret about not having a certain ingredient. It will just taste different or look different. It's not the end of the world. You're not in the West End of London. You're not a Michelin star. No one's gonna throw you out or fire you for missing an ingredient. You're at home. Enjoy it, embrace it. Right, in goes the turmeric and the curry powder. I'm gonna roll that around our onions, garlic, and Oh, ginger. Sorry, that's, I mean, if you ain't getting smells off that, you're doing something wrong. That is banging. Okay, so that's quite thick. I've got the wrong pan, but we don't know. Right, kettle on. We need 300ml of veg stock and 100ml of coconut milk eventually, or chicken stock eventually. So, if you've got one of these Knorr stock cubes, I'd say about half. You don't want, if you put in a whole one, it's gonna be really effing salty. So let's just put half, sorry, why am I doing this off camera, like a plum? Off camera, idiot. Right, chicken stock, half a stock cube, and 300ml of boiling water, okay? Coconut milk's going afterwards, but before that, we've got to put the flour in. We make what's called a roux. If you don't know what a roux is, it's the base of most sauces, including bechamel and cheese sauce. Keep stirring, because those herbs will catch if you don't have it quite low. So remember, still low heat, we're not trying to char anything. Thank you, Natasha, for subscribing. Ha, look at all these followers. Just keep going with that and share it with your friends. Honestly, there is not one person I don't want to help. Okay, hang on 2 seconds, I might have locked my family out. They're good. Bless them. They are so good to me. They just like, I crack on with this and you guys, and they just like hover around and play in the garden and stuff. Right, 300ml. Let's go. Enough chat, Ben. Like my mum said, just get on with it. Cheers, mum. Ever the supportive parent. I'm joking. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be in this mess. Right, okay. 300ml of chicken stock. Are we all up to date? I need feedback from my mother. Hey Zeus, how you doing, man? I need feedback from my mother, Sarah Cooling, Pippa McKean if she's cooking. Anyone that's cooking along, everyone else stop typing. If you're cooking along, are you at the stage where your onions are nice and soft and you've got your curry powder around them and you're ready to add your flour? Bosh. No one else talk for a bit. Let the guys that are cooking along come into the frame, ask their questions, and they're burning the house down. You should have a really nice, oh, just smells like it's so good. I'm good, Zeus, mate, I'm good, bruv. Nice, Pippa. Mum, Sarah, I know you're cooking along. Let's see how you go. We'll just take a chill. How's everyone going? I know I asked to just ask the question. We're just waiting to hear back from Mum's okay. Yeah, Samantha's in. Oh, Sam's in as well. Yeah, everyone's up to date. Oh, and Aaron and Lorna. Ooh. Congratulations. Everyone else, crack on. They're up to date. Okay, so you bang the flour in and you should have a really stodgy kind of thick onion curry powder. I mean, look at the state of that. You can make barges out of that, can you? Now, this is where we gradually being the key word, add our chicken or vegetable stock, okay? Now, if 300ml isn't enough, because there's more onion in there or too much flour, then just keep adding it until it turns into a nice little paste, okay? I'll show you the consistency. So you want about 50ml at a time and stir it in. Keep it on a low heat. This is not a race, okay? Once the sauce is done, I still reckon I can do this in 45 minutes. Once the sauce is done, the rest of it is just dreamy. Make sure your kettle's still boiled. I'm gonna flip mine back on. And then, okay, so just keep adding your stock. 50ml, 75ml at a time. Stir it in gently. And you'll see curry powder and the flour, more importantly, will start to make it into a nicer, thicker paste, okay? And there we go. Another addition of stock. I know I'm not looking at the camera, I apologise. I will, once someone sponsors me or funds me, get an aerial camera and everything will be Gucci. But at the moment, you just got to put up with the back of my bald head. Okay? Oh, just Lorna? Where's Aaron at? Any salt and pepper? No, Mum. Did I ask you to put salt and pepper in? Did I say to put salt and pepper in? No. Comes at the end. Sorry, Mum. I apologise profusely. Okay, and the rest of the stock can go in and you'll have a nice, not thick, paste. We're going to let that cook out a little bit because no one wants to taste of flour, do they? I don't know anyone that likes to taste of flour. You see it in prank jokes where they just get their mates and just throw a ball of flour. No one likes that. So, we're going to let that cook out for a little bit And then we're gonna add our coconut milk and sit it to one side and let it chill, okay? How is everyone going? A bit tight, that apron. You can talk, mate. You put a picture of you doing something with a sword the other week and I thought it was someone else. Chunky monkey. Come at me on my show, giving me that apron looks a bit tight. What can you replace the chicken with? Right, okay, so Ruth, I know you're veggie or vegan. I did put a veggie and vegan option in the menu, aubergine. So what you can do is when we go for the chicken, we're gonna dust it with flour, egg, and panko breadcrumbs. Now, I know a couple of you had trouble getting panko breadcrumbs. I apologize for that. They are better than regular breadcrumbs. In fact, the stuff you get from Paxo on the supermarket shelf, you may as well throw in the bin. It's like they've been swept, it's like floor sweepings. What you want to do, if you can't get panko, which are Japanese breadcrumbs, super, super dried, so they're extra crispy, is make them yourself. Put on some toast, let the toast sit on the edge, on the side, put it in the oven for a little bit on a low heat, about 50 to 100 degrees, a few minutes, and then put it in a blender and you've got breadcrumbs, okay? There's no need to keep buying processed pish. Is that allowed in the watershed? I know I'm not allowed to swear. From the supermarket, it does my napper in. Right. Sauce should look a little bit, let's not lower the tone, like a korma sauce maybe, okay? Put that on the lowest heat you've got and forget about it for a time being, okay? And get a pan of boiling water on for your greens. But you got a good shot on my bald spot then. I know for a fact you did. So you're welcome. Speaking of which, anyone growing facial lockdown fuzz or anything like that? No? Okay, just me. What's that? Grind up some stale bread for breadcrumbs, Doritos. There we go. Yeah, look at this. Look at these. Amazing techers. So 100ml of coconut oil is going to go into your curry sauce. 100ml. And then stir that in and let that reduce, okay? Just leave it on the side, chilling. And what we'll do after it's chilled a little bit and reduced and got a bit thicker, we'll add some soy sauce, some sugar if we need it. We'll taste it, mother. And add some salt and pepper. We won't, we'll just put the sugar and the soy in because the soy's got enough salt in it. And then we'll pass it through a sieve and that's our sauce, okay? Just leave that chilling. Right, people cooking along, everyone happy? Sauce isn't very thick yet. Okay, so Sarah, did you sauteed off, you softened the onions and added the garlic and the ginger. Yeah, and then you add the turmeric, which you didn't have because you got in contact, the curry powder. And that should make it quite powdery and like a paste. And then you add flour, which should really dry it out. Keeping the heat on that the whole time and then add the stock. Mmm. If it's not very thick, just leave it on the stove, as I've done there, and forget about it. Lowest heat you can, and forget about it. Okay, next, rice. You saw me earlier, 100 grams in that pan there. Then we take, so the rules of rice for me, personally, I like it sticky, is one part rice to two part water. But we're gonna do, sod the sieve, well done, Mum. Oh, John, well done, Zeus. John who? Ginger, a thumb nut, a 2.5 centimetres, about an inch. The end of your thumb. Bang that in there. Edwina, lovely blast from the past. How are you, my love? Sod the sieve. Mum, where did John ask? Sorry, I need to catch up. Morts, hello, mate. Right, John, where's John? Which John? Zeus, which John? Come at me, bro. Who needs help with the ginger? I've lost it. Thank you, Zeus, for bringing that to my attention. Appreciate it. Spud, Mr. Robertson, hope you're well. Right, let's reset. Sauce is on. Sorry, I got carried away. I've had a coffee. We're gonna do the rice. 100 grams or 120 grams of rice, and then double what liquid you're putting in. What we're gonna do is, we're gonna take 100 ml of boiling water, do it in front of you. 100 ml of boiling water, and then 100 ml of coconut milk. Oh, what? Yeah, coconut milk. So, let's take 100 ml of boiling water. You have got coconut milk, because it goes in the sauce. If you haven't got it, just use water. Don't fret, never fret. So there's the water going with the rice. And here comes the coconut milk. 100 ml, beautiful. Let's get that in there. Don't worry about it. Take a whisk. Make sure that milk and that milk and water combination is all around the grains. Get it on heat. Bring it up and then break it down. You've all cooked rice before, you don't need to tell that. Just the addition of coconut milk may freak you out, but it makes for a smoother, nicer touch. How is everyone doing? People that are cooking along? Oh, sorry, John. Thanks, mate. Well done for cooking along. Thank you very much. You need some company, weirdo. Those that are cooking along, are you up to the same place I am? Let's take a little 5-minute respite. Rest bite, whatever the correct English is. And I'll stop talking for a second, if you're lucky. Right, let's have a little chill. Nice and easy. I'm the one working here, you guys are learning, yeah?
Yeah.
Samantha's good, Sarah's good. Pippa and my mother, how are you guys going, all right? Probably I'll pour another glass of wine. Good evening, Mr. Wilde. Hope you're well in our current climate, considering. Blah, blah, blah. I will do carbonara for you, Tom, but you have to pay for a lesson. And also, it's not really a takeaway meal, is it? This is Friday night fake away. Okay, so sauce on the low heat, just reducing nicely. Rice, you've just put in some water and some coconut milk and you need to give that a stir so it doesn't catch. And once it starts bubbling, boiling, whatever word terminology you want to use, once it starts bubbling, boiling, you turn it down to a simmer and put a lid on it. Fine so far. Good God, you guys, my sauce is crazy. Good. Mate, you need that Coots carbonara, mate. It's one of my favourites. Pritch, good to see you, bruv. Now, prediction's easy. Sauce is done, rice is on. Should have a pan of boiling water. If you haven't, boil the kettle. We can wait, relax. I'm going to do some greens. Because the chicken's the last thing to go. It's just there for show. In fact, let's move that out of the way. Now, I've got some tender stem broccoli. Now, if I was on the telly, it wouldn't be in a packet, but I'm not yet. Yet. So, you'll find supermarket broccoli. You'll want to take the end off it. Not too much. Don't go like, oh no, it's brown. Just nip the ends off it. I don't know what you guys are doing at home. Maybe you're doing some like leaves and dressing. Maybe you're doing some wilt with spinach. Oh, man, I mean broccoli, because my wife very generously went to the shops and got it. Well, she didn't go to the shops, actually, we got it delivered because we're not allowed to go to the shops. Boiling water, punch of salt, I'm joking. Good fingering of salt. And let's drop that in there. On a low heat, yeah? Tell you now, my rice has come up to the boil, so I'm gonna knock it down in temperature and let that just simmer away in the background. And now, this is where we can all have a chat. So, I need to know where you all are emotionally. No, I'm joking. I need to know, sauce is on and reducing. We'll add some soy sauce to that later and pass it through. My greens are on in the pan there, and my rice is doing its ting in the corner, which means the last thing is a pan of oil, shallow fried. Mine's a bit hot at the moment, so I'm gonna pull that off. That's what she said. And that's how we're gonna do our chicken. Jimmy, how you doing, mate? Now, you worked at Wagamamas, so hopefully this is all going well. Mr. Field, hello, Carol. Sorry, Mr. People. We can get Italian takeaway here, so carbonara is takeout. Hello. Right, chicken comes in two parts, the breast. There's a fillet, which lies in here. That's what goes in KFC. And then you've got your breast, yeah? We're gonna cut that in half, but I'm gonna do a butchery lesson for you. Take your palm, your hand, which is about the same size as a chicken fillet, incidentally, so you can feel your way through it. Put it on top, go halfway through, look under, and just bring the knife towards you nice and sharp. Absolutely, look at that. Come across, and that is what you'll get on a griddle or a barbecue. There's a butterfly piece of chicken. I'm gonna do mine in half, Sorry, I'm just washing my knife and hand. And come down the middle. Boom. Katsu curry panko. And I'm going to do the fillet as well, because I'm a fat git. Right, so that's our chicken part done. How are we looking? Those cooking along? Mate, Jimmy, take my KFC fake away from two weeks ago and fill your boots, mate. Good to have you on board and watching. Get a beer on the go, you're golden. Okay, so, Mr. Harrison, using thighs. Mum, in that case, if you're using thighs, are they filleted? Is it bone in or out, and is it skin on or off? Good evening, Mr. Harrison. Good evening, Dino. Good evening, Tom. Welcome to the party. Making Wagamama's katsu chicken. Our rice is on, our sauce is done, basically. Got a few greens in the corner there, and we're about to go chicken panko breadcrumb datches. Right, guys cooking along, you need three things. This is called panne in the restaurants. You need flour. You can have it seasoned or unseasoned. Now, this is a good opportunity to beef up the flavours of what you're going to breadcrumb the chicken in, okay? So, I'm just going to nip over here, and I'm going to get myself some paprika and some garlic powder. Don't fret if you haven't got it. Just relax a little bit. Okay, and I'm just going to season my flour. If you ever breadcrumb stuff, you can season the flour or the breadcrumbs. You can put some Italian herbs in the breadcrumbs just to give whatever you're breadcrumbing a little bit of an edge. Stir your rice, stir your sauce, make sure nothing's catching, maybe kill the heat on a few. And let's get into that panne in. Okay, so, which if I do this the wrong way around, it should be flour, eggs, breadcrumb, but I don't know which way it goes to you guys. And then on to a tray. What's that? Stop faffing around. Yeah, we'll do. Okay, so, in the industry, we have a wet hand and we have a dry hand. Okay, now, chicken is wet. Put it in, flip it over in the flour. Hope you can see all this. Yeah, you can. Okay, then, dry. Flour is dry. Egg is wet. In it goes, wet hand. Trust me, when you do 1500 Parmigianas in an Italian restaurant in Melbourne, you learn this pretty quick. And then panko breadcrumbs dry. Okay, and we fold it around. Get as much as we can on there. You want to really thump it down, okay? Don't be scared of it. Make a mess if you have to, I'll just have. Have some fun. Right, and that is just the fillet. Once it bulks out. So again, wet hand. The chicken is flesh, it's wet. Put it into the flour, give it a shake if you need to. Dry hand, flour is dry. Yeah? Shake off all that excess flour into the egg, wet hand. Egg is wet. Okay, and then last one, into the panko. Now, the reason it's panko breadcrumbs is because panko breadcrumbs are the nuts. Sorry, I went off camera there, but did you miss me? They're just drier and I don't know the history of them. They're Japanese and they're crispy can get. I don't know what they did. They must have been effing bored. They just thought, you know what, let's do it for it. So, and that is one, my days. Last one, wet hand. I'm sure a lot of you are talking and commenting at the moment. Can you do the chicken cut again? It's such a no, because this is the only fillet I've got. And if that was banter, well played, sir. We haven't done the soy sauce in the sauce yet, Mum, because it gets the saltiness and the flavour of soy sauce gets cooked out, and you need that depth. If you put it in now, it gets lost in the curry sauce. So we've got the last fillet into the panko. I'm just gonna wash my hands, guys. It's my wet hand, dry hand combo got interrupted with questions, which I love. I love it, I love it, I love it. Mr. Fear. Yes, I can. I'm doing steak for a group next week, actually, Mr. Fear. And yes, I can. I absolutely can. And I can do it in your kitchen instead of everyone doing it on a Komodo Joe barbecue. That's all the trend. But you need £500 for the barbecue in the first place, don't you? Yeah, lucky anyone's got £500 in lockdown. Twat. Right, so you should have maybe a fillet, but definitely two breasts that have been butterflied. Well done, congratulations. That's our panne. Everyone up to speed? Come at me. How's everyone's rice? Mine's pretty much done.
sauce is done. Veggies are on a nice medium heat, so they're done. My rice looks like rice pudding. It's going to be so luxurious. Okay, back to you guys. Oh, you can wash the rice. Yeah, I just don't like mine really sticky. It's smelling delish. Good. Oh, thank you, Jimmy. Yeah, well, I'll try my best. Mr. G-Mac, how to do it again? Quentin, yes, you can wash your rice. You can do it four times, in all fairness, to get all that starchiness out and make it fluffy. I like the starchy, cheap stuff because it sticks together and then I can bang it in a mould, which I'll show you later. What I'm going to do is put a bit of oil in this whiskey tumbler, push the rice into it, drop it out, and it will stick together. Some rice, if you want it light and fluffy, then yes, pre-wash your rice, but this is my show. No, I'm joking. Yes, you can, is the answer. It's completely personal taste. Thanks, ma'am. Right, okay, so, mum, you can add the soy sauce. Teaspoon of soy sauce to your sauce. Does everyone else's look quite yellow and like that, and with bits of onion floating in it? Don't worry, we're gonna pass it. So a teaspoon of light soy sauce, then we're gonna taste that, and then we're gonna add a bit of sugar. Like I said, guys, I need you to follow on Insta, Facebook, all that crap. We'll come to that at the end. And also, I need you to subscribe to the YouTube, because then that'll make it awesome. Those cooking along. Yeah, there probably is. Thanks for that, Mort, but you've written it too long. I've got Seymour, I'm not gonna touch that. What are you doing with the costed chicken? Coated. Yes, it does stop it sticking, Mum. You're very correct, but I'm going for sticky rice. God, I didn't realise this would be that hard. Right, this is my rice. It's got coconut milk and water in it. It's done. I'm going to leave it on the side. It's going to be lovely. This is my pan. It's at a medium. You want it on a low heat, and I'm going to drop my chicken in it. This is my other pan. It's got my greens in it. And that's my sauce. Now, while the chicken is cooking in the low temperature oil, we are going to finish off the sauce, and then we're going to plate up, and Robert's your father's brother. I'm so lock stock. Right, okay. Again, we're dealing with oil here, guys, so dip the tip in. Hey-o! Dip the tip in. Make sure your pan's got a bit of fizz, and then place it away from you, okay? In. And then just roll the chicken fillet away from you. I can't even fit the wee man in. I'll find some room. Another title. Right. You don't want roaring temperatures here, guys. You really don't. You want a nice low temp on your shallow fry. Tidy up shallow fry chicken breadcrumb. How is everyone doing? Lorna, Pippa, my mum, Sarah. Oh crap, I forgot the name of the other one. Sorry for the swearing. Whoever's cooking along, how are you getting on? You good? You happy? You know it? Clap your hands. Let's get ready to plate up, chef. Cheers, everybody. Right, the sauce. Let's do this. Get yourself a jug or another pan or a bowl or whatever you effing well like. Check your sauce. And now this is where we're gonna taste, Mum. So a little bit of sugar, just to bring out the flavors a little bit, tease them out. Take that bitterness away, because there will be bitterness from the turmeric and the curry powder, okay? So just a little bit of sugar, maybe a bit more, because I've just got an aftertaste of bitterness. And that sugar, yeah, like I said, takes out the bitterness. If you put sugar into a tomato soup or a bolognese, it brings out the sweetness of the tomato. But we're trying to neutralize the bitterness of the curry powders, okay? So a little bit of sugar into there. Now, Mum, you said, don't worry about the sieve. That's completely up to you. This is the consistency I have my sauce at. We're gonna take a sieve, contrary to my mother's beliefs, and I'm gonna try my hardest, one-handed or two-handed, to pass it through this sieve. Now guys, this is something we do for restaurants for richness and all the rest of it. I don't expect, if it doesn't go well, we'll just have it with onions in, shall we? So what you do, a little bit at a time. Oh, sugar. You push the sauce and eradicate the rest. Okay, so what will happen is you'll have a load of onions and funk left. Now, if you can't be bothered to do this, that's fine. But know this, every jus, sauce, awesome gravy, and other stuff you have in restaurants, some poor commie has done this until he doesn't want to see the bottom of a sieve again. Hear it again? Right, sit still, you. So this is called passing. Make sure your chicken's not burning. This is called passing, and it just makes soups, sauces, everything else that much smoother. Like I said, you don't have to do it. Mum, if you want to just bowl it straight from the... Oh, I've got it on the edge. Fired, I'm absolutely fired. Chef White's taken off, go home, early service. Mum, if you want to bung it in with the onions and have that thickness, that's great. I'm doing it my way, you do it your way. That's the whole point of this. I'm not judging. You can do it whatever you want. I can smell my chicken burning. 2 steps. Oh, hello. Forgot that's a big old wok burner in the moment. Right, not burning at all. Put a bit. Gonna move it to a slightly less aggressive burner. And carry on passing. Right, how are we all doing, guys? Are we passing or are we just not be bothered? This is why you pay extra money in the posh places. The time and effort it goes in to make everything taste nice. I'll catch up. Right, Zeus is wondering how it turns out with panko. Fuck off, CFP. Quick bit of trivia. The chicken katsu curry remained completely unchanged from 99. Oh, hello. Someone knows his staff handbook. You know what I'm going to do with this leftovers, though? I'm going to make barges or something. Because there's too much flavour in there not to have it. Right. Oh, have I made a mess? Of course I have. Let's get it home. I'll clear all that. Right, so there's our sauce. Chicken's on the way. 5 minutes. I've done it in 45 minutes again. I'm so impressed with myself. I'll get and I'll look at all your questions in a minute, guys. I'm just making a mess of this jug and plate. But I can rectify that. Crumbs. Back in 2 seconds. Talk amongst yourselves, hope your chicken's all right. Well, I'm about to turn mine. How are you all getting on? How are y'all? Lovely. Oh, golden brown. Texture like sun. Right, sauce done. Tidy up that jug. Giggity. Sorry guys, 2 seconds, I'm just copying one sink for 30 seconds and make sure everything looks nice. So, if you've got greens on, let me know how they're going. Probably worth a check. Make sure they're nice and al dente instead of your mum's or nan's soup. Right, is that good for television? There's my katsu curry sauce. Absolutely banging. Here's our plate, we're ready to go in a minute. Yes, Mr. Fry, Nicola, long time. Jenny, how we doing, man? Sorry, I was doing passing and also that takes away my concentration from you guys. Hello, this is Cooking with Coots. You need to share, like, subscribe, hit like and love. And I'm gonna start playing up in a minute and make it all Gucci. Right, we need a glass. Right, a little bit of oil. Doesn't matter what, olive oil, veg oil, castor oil, you just need a bit of lube, all right? Put that in your glass or a teacup. Get your fingers in there, work it around. Trust me. Take your rice, spoon it in. That coconut rice. No seasoning, just coconut. You can do it with stock, veg stock or chicken stock. Completely up to you. I don't care. It's personal preference. We're not cooking for the Queen or in a Michelin-style restaurant. You do you. Have some fun. God, look how hot I look. Not like that. Obviously, the face buzz is an absolute magnet, but. So you grease the rim. Leave that on there, all right? Bit of broccoli action, just to make sure that's cooked. Get your knife. Well, jack, boot that up a bit. And then finally your chicken. That's off the heat. We're good to go.
We're good to go. How's everyone looking? What's Joe doing? We'll need to cut my thighs longer.
No, not necessarily, Mum. Have you got a pro? If you haven't, get one of these. They're about £8. A pro. For a barbecue, if you don't want to eat raw sausage over the summer because you got too pissed, sorry, you got too drunk, and you try to do a barbecue, and then one of the sausages gives your guest food poisoning. Whatever reason, get a pro. Be safe. Don't be a moron. There are chefs that have worked for years and years and years that know exactly how the feel and the look of something knows that it cooked, okay? You're not one of them unless you've been in the industry, so get a pro.
Wow, I've missed a lot.
Right, so, there's our little... Honestly, I couldn't be happier with that. Look at that. There's our little tower of rice. Should we just look at that? Let's just take a second. And it's that simple. Coconut milk. Water or stock if you were going fancy. Cheap ass Morrison's rice. Put it in a cup, looks the tits, don't it? Here's another tip. Take a baking tray or anything you've got. Piece of kitchen roll, all right? Do this for poached eggs in the morning as well. For the love of God. And when you're taking something out of a hot pan that's got fat, all your poached eggs with the dripping oil, give that a bit more blast. Just a little bit of, on a tray, a little bit of kitchen roll as a blotter. Hang on, I've lost myself here. Just gonna give that chicken a little bit of a razz up. Got the thing you got us when we were cooking for Christmas. God, that was like 12 years ago, Mum. Sweating like John Leslie on a first date. Yeah, sweating like Michael. Oh, he's dead. Yeah, good one. Greens, we're done. Sorry, I got discombobulated chatting to you guys. Just gonna pass me greens, sieve me greens out. Now, I'm gonna show you something that I'm gonna do, but I don't want you guys to follow it thinking, oh, well, people show me this and that's how you do it in the restaurant. It's not. I'm gonna take my chicken out. I'm gonna put it on my tray. And that tray is gonna soak up the fatty bits. And then I'm only doing this because I'm home and I'm an absolute, I've had a beer. I'm just gonna toss my broccoli and make it a little bit fatter. Please don't do this at home. All right, it's just because I felt like it. John T, hello, John T. Thank you. Please pass my thanks on. To your dad, he's been an absolute hero. Guys, what else we got? We're gonna go, 45 minutes, is 2 minutes away. Oh, I know what you're after, chopping time. Okay. Can you hear that? Crispy! Cooked. What more do you want from me? This is a little bit indulgent. Where's my tongs gone? Tongs. Bit of greenage, which is completely just now chips because I put it in the oil of the panko. There we go, look. And last not the least, basically that's crumb chicken, rice and greens. Just boring as food, yeah. Last but not least, the very well done to everyone who cooked along. The only thing that makes this not bland chicken panko is your katsu sauce. Yeah. I'm not a very arrogant man. I come across as it, I'm not. I'm just confident at things I can do. And I can do cooking. So check that out. Wagamamas, yes, it took 45 minutes, but you can do it at home now. Which sauce? Yes, John. Yeah. So hit like, follow, subscribe to YouTube, share it with your mates if you think they'll like it. Also, by all means, send me constructive criticism. I'm very new to this. Like I said, COVID forced my hand, but I'm enjoying it and I want to make something of it and I want to be on the telly. If you know anyone on the telly, I'll quite happily do it. No, you shut. No, stop it. You behave. Right, any questions? If you want to get in touch, just DM me. Go onto the website. If you want lessons, you can do an hour's lesson. You can do a block of four. You can cook whatever you want. They're completely bespoke. You can say, yo, Coops, I want to learn how to do beef bourguignon. Yo, Coops, I want to learn how to barbecue like a master. Yo, Coops, whatever it is, get in touch. An hour won't cost you anything. Well, it'll cost you 35 quid, but you'll get knowledge and everything else. So yes, if you are and you're in lockdown, it doesn't matter. If your confidence isn't there or you want to go shopping for a day, I'll do it all. I'm building it as we go. But you can have me and in person for a whole day. We can go knife shopping if you like. That's me. Oh, Pippa, I'm glad. A lot better than last week as far as I'm concerned. Well done. Thanks, Mum. Less swearing, I reckon. Right, honestly, don't forget the tip. Put it in a cup, push it down with a spoon. Look how I'm sweating. And then you'll get a nice tower, lovely. Chicken, panko breadcrumbs, a lot dry. Lorna, checking in with Lorna. You were cooking along. People pay 15 quid for that. You're welcome. Oh my God. I can see why you'd go out and eat and be seen at Wagamama's sharing a table with a load of people that you don't know. But I'd rather make it at home. And I know if you're vegan, you can do it as well as OG. Right. Thank you. 45 minutes, as promised-ish. Lorna, I'm just waiting to hear from you. And now, the rest of you that are watching, please do try it. Watch it back. It's not hard. I'll put all the ingredients up and it'll be on my Facebook page. And then I'll upload it to YouTube. And I don't do anything to it. I don't edit it. I don't have the skill set at the moment. I just basically launch it onto YouTube and let people watch it. Well done, Lorna. I'm glad you got it. Oh, it passed the dad test. It is incredible. Thank you, Samantha. I think me and you are going to be friends. I'm enjoying it. I hope you are too. Like I said, like, follow, get in touch if you want lessons. I've done them to America. Basically a FaceTime lesson, it was amazing. Have a great weekend, guys. Like I said, it is Mental Health Awareness Week. Just touch base with your mates. Make sure they're good. Don't milk it, like, if they're all right, they're all right. And I'll see you again next week. Oh, next week, Nando's. Who doesn't like Nando's? We're gonna do Nando's. Just chicken legs, some corn, nice and simple. Just to end the month. And then we'll go big for June. And me and Mr. Ollie Ramsey will talk about barbecue and stuff. Right, hit like, share, follow, subscribe. Have a great weekend. Cheers, guys. Love you lots. Take care. Bye-bye.